Hello, everyone, and welcome back to Let's Play Suikoden 5, baby. In the last episode, we put Barrows in his goddamn place, and it's time to move out of Rainwall, because fuck that guy. It's on to Rafleet. Apparently, that's going to be our new base of operations. I am down to clown with that. At least for now, it will be our base of operations. I wonder if the ever-moving base of operations will be a thing in this game, or we will finally settle down somewhere. I do not know. Rafleet would be kind of a weird place to settle down with everybody in the army. I mean, if we end up getting the whole 108 recruits, it's going to be a little weird to have them all in Rafleet. But it might be cool to have a little bit of a different place to hang out, you know? Anyway, here's my crew. I fucking didn't even reformation them, so this is probably a bad formation. But anyway, the biggest thing that happened in the last episode is we got the motherfucking Dawn Rune, baby. The Dawn Rune is now in my possession. It is on Funky G's right hand, I assume. I haven't even actually looked at it. I have done nothing of the sort, because it was literally right at the end of last episode. Dawn Rune is in my... I guess that's right or left. I can't tell. I guess that's right hand.
Time of Awakening. Remove status
changes from all allies, so it's a healing rune. That's good to know. Use the Dawn Rune on him, so said stupid Urim Barrows. He was like... He gave it away, man. You should have known he was going to give everything away. In fact, I didn't need to know. Lucretia knew everything. That girl be smart as fuck. Anyway, I'm not going to swap my team formation quite yet. Let's just get back to Rafleet, see what happens cutscene-wise, and then we'll get cracking on our next whatever story thing is, because I have no friggin' idea what's going to be our next step. Let's see what the next step is. We're here in Rafleet. Let's talk to Raja and tell her all the problems that we have. Yeah. Also, let's check on the trade guy real quick to see, because I haven't tried him in a minute. Let me see. You got more salt? He's got more salt! Buying it. Do we have 20 fucking 6 salts now? Price of fruit has skyrocketed. Come on, man. When's the price of salt gonna skyrocket? Is my grandchild Shinro stupid? Yeah. So are you. God damn it, Syro. One of these days, Syro. One of these days. Okay, so we are heading to the main ship just so we can tell Raja all about the bullshit that we just went down in mother effing Rainwall. And then, from there, maybe something will happen. I don't know. Until I can switch my party members again, I'm kind of stuck doing whatever the story wants me to do. Because there is some stuff I can do here now that we are in Rafleet as our main base of operations. But I have to wait until I can change my party members, because I don't think I can do that right now with Lucerina in my actual party. I need to make it so I can change people. So let's go talk to Raja and hope that will trigger whatever I need to trigger. Raja, where are you? I am here. Come to me. Come to me. There we go. And here's Kisara.
Ah, there you are. Kisara told me everything. I want you to think of this place as your new home from now on. Much less stuffy than Rainwall, isn't it?
Much, much less. Yes, and in more ways than one. Thank you very much, Raja. Nice. All right, we're here, and we're here to stay. All right, crew is here.
So that old snake even stole the Dawn Rune, eh?
Don't tell me you knew about that too, Lucretia. Well, I did have my suspicions, yes. But I wanted proof. That's why I had Oboro look into it. I was hoping we could reach a more amicable agreement with Lord Barrows, but Urim let the secret slip. I'm sorry this has all been so hard on you, Lucerina. After what my father and brother did, they had this coming to them in the end. Some might even say they got off easy. I just wish there was some way I could apologize to His Highness, to Lady Sileet, and to the people of Lord Lake. I don't know what to say to them, but you can't imagine how terrible I feel.
You can't beat yourself up, though. I mean, I was as close to Lord Barrows as anyone, and I never suspected a thing. Enough of the blame game. Let's keep on fighting so that the future's not filled with more guys like him.
Yeah.
Absolutely. My resolve is stronger than ever, Lord Wild.
Ha 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 ha, no problem. Can't believe you're related to those crew creeps, though.
Well, Your Highness, what should be our next course of action?
I read that wrong, but that's okay. We have to get more allies. Let's save Lord Lake, dude. I'm down with that. Let's do that. Let's save Lord Lake.
Yes, if anyone's a victim in all this, it's Lord Lake. But nobody's ever lifted a finger to help them. No more! Yes, Prince, we need to help them. It's long, long overdue.
Time to go on a little trip, then.
What do you mean? Are we going to move Raffleet over there? That'd be pretty sweet.
Admiral, I'll have everybody move Raffleet closer to Lord Blake.
Oh, okay. That works. Can we still come back over here, though? Because I need to come back over here. Whatever, everyone fucking left the party. Fine, I don't want any of those people in my party anyways. Alright, so Raffleet is now moving away from Rainwall, because fuck Rainwall. Off to Lord Lake area. Sweet. I'm down for that. And so we moveth.
I didn't realize there was three, like, Hydra dragons on the front of the boat. That's pretty cool.
That's pretty cool.
Oh, here we go.
Word of mouth is a frightening thing, Father. Most of the Barrows nobles have either gone independent or joined the prince's cause. The Barrows family is almost completely isolated now.
Just as I predicted, Lucretia ate them alive. And it's just a matter of time before the prince becomes her next meal.
Indeed, but I can't help but think Lord Barrows deserved his fate.
Absolutely. The political game is all about retribution. Karma, if you will.
And you don't have any of those? BS bullshit. You got so much karma coming back on you pretty soon here, buddy. Don't even try to act like you ain't got none of that.
Errors and judgment will always come back to haunt you in the end. Always. We should both keep that in mind.
Indeed. Okay, indeed.
And if the stories about the prince and the Dawn Rune are to be believed, we've got a decision ahead of us.
True. The scholars haven't made any substantial progress yet, though. We may well have to rely on a backup plan for now.
What kind of backup plan you thinking, huh? Bring it. Whatever it is, I got you, homie. I got you. You ain't gonna stop me, Jizzle. No way. No way, no how. Beat him up like blizzity, blizzity, blip, blow. Do we really need that view? I mean, it didn't even show us, like, where we are. It just showed a view of the fact that we're in Raffleet.
Whatever.
Because now we get another loading screen. Yay.
Yes,
oh, wait.
Me.
Hold on.
Shh. May I come in?
Yes! Back in the other outfit.
That
thank
looks
God.
Stunning.
Well, different
yes,
outfit,
that
but better.
On you. Hurry up. Let's go show everybody. Come on.
Sick. So that's the outfit they show in the opening sequence when you start up the game. Finally, I'm stopped wearing that stupid orange outfit. I mean, it's still orange, but it's not stupid. Anyway.
Well, well, take a look at that.
Yeah, hell yeah. Looking pretty sharp, your highness. Hey, hey, hey.
What? Only for Gigi? Why don't I get a fancy new costume? No fair, it's always this way. No, this is just for the prince. To be honest, up until now, people have thought of him as little more than a puppet of Lord Barrows. We have to show them that prince isn't just an honorary title. We need to show him he's a real leader. And you really think playing dress-up is the best way to show that?
Bitch, please. That outfit was ugly and you know it.
It's a start, but you're right. A new costume alone won't solve everything. With that in mind, I think we should also come up with a new name for the prince's forces.
Dude, is this really going to be our place to stay? Because we're going to come up with our army name and everything?
A name for us, in other words, unless you want the enemy to keep calling us the rebel army and those traitors.
No, I don't. So, a new name for us, huh? How about the... Oh, here we go. We're in this situation again. God damn it. God damn it. I did not come up with an idea for this. Anyway, how about the Orange Army or the Unicorn Army?
No, something simple is the best option. How about just the Prince's Army? I like the sound of that. What do you think, Your Highness?
Okay, I guess I get to name my army. What do I name them, dude? I never know what to name them. Should I go with what I picked in, like, previous games? I think I did this in one of the previous games, right? I put G... Dash... F... O... R... S... E... That's not an S, that's a C. Force... G-Force Army, baby! I think I did that before, right? Because they're the motherfucking G-Force, you know. Is that what we do? We rock them with the funky G-Force, baby! I'm down for that. Let's just do that. I don't want to sit here and think about this for 10 minutes, so let's just fucking do it. It doesn't really matter that much. It's not like I have another Suikoden game that comes after this that I could load it into anyways. Anyways.
The G-Force Army.
Works for me!
Now then, Prince. Let's talk about our first military operation as the G-Force Army.
I keep mixing up fucking... I keep trying not to do Sia leads while I'm doing Lucretia's voice.
I need to be more deadpan with Lucretia's voice.
Now then, Prince, let's talk about our first military operation as the G-Force Army. Now that Barrows is gone, I'll take over the organization of our forces. In the meantime, I want you to go to Lord Lake. This is very important, Your Highness. For I feel the fate of Lord Lake is intertwined with the very fate of Felina itself.
Sounds like a plan to me, dude. Let's do it. I'm down. Lord Lake, here I come to save you! Should I get to pick my party? Where's Lucerina? Or are you gonna do it?
Good luck with Lord Lake, Your Highness. I will do whatever I can from here.
Alright, what about you, Silence?
That old coot must have been hiding the Dawn Room all this time because he couldn't figure out how to bear it. He's a damn fool, and his foolishness has thrown Felina into chaos.
Indeed. What about you?
The people of Lord Lake have been suffering from the Queen's action for 2 years. It won't be easy to win them over to our side. But we have to try.
Yes, we do. What about you, Kisara?
You can walk to Lord Lake from here.
All right, well, that's the plan, maybe. Where the hell is everyone else? They must be around here somewhere if this is my new place of residence. This might end up actually being the final place we stay. We'll see. I mean, it'd be fine if it is. But, I don't know, it just depends. Anyway, look who's hanging around outside the bath. No surprise there.
Hey, nice duds, Prince. You look about 5 times manlier than usual. Stupid fucking orange dress you're wearing is ugly as shit. If I were a girl, I wouldn't be able to keep my hands off you. And then, I can't keep my hands off you anyways, let alone the fact that you're not a girl.
Okay, dude, nobody's taking a bath yet. God damn it. I just want somebody to be in the bath when I get in there, man. I know that's what Kyle's hoping. All right, anyway. Let's see if we can find Lucerina. That's who we need to find. She's gonna be my way to change party members. Hey, boss. Dub dub.
We didn't whip General Novum early bad enough. That means he'll probably be back to try again. He'll probably take his army across the revolving bridge, but if that bridge didn't work...
Oh, are you implying that we should do something to the bridge? I'm down.
Suddenly, I find myself upon a ship for reasons distressingly unknown. But I hardly mind, as long as I get to trounce those filthy Godwin devils and travel to the very center of hell!
Alright, Eggbird dude, calm your tits, dude. Anyway, here's my party member change of person.
I didn't want to leave Mother behind like that, but the servant should take good care of her. I'm prepared to lay down my life for you to make up for my family's misdeeds.
Can I change party members?
You wish to change your paddling companions, do you? Do you?
Alright, yes I do. So, what I want to do is, I'm trying to look over at my guide. We need to do a couple things. We need to put Takamu back in here. Takamu, boo. Yep. I shall chart us a course at once. As for the rest of my party, is there anyone else I need, or is he the only one I literally need? I'm just double checking all of my current headings if there's anyone I need for any of them. I don't think so. Okay. Doesn't look like I need anybody specific. So let's just bring a party and let's do it. Let's see. Who do I want? Let's bring Kyle. We haven't really used Kyle in a while. We used him like very early on in the game, but I don't think we ever actually got to like use him. Who else have we not used much in a while? Well, you know, let's put Silene back in there. Maybe she'll be of use. Plus, I need some long-range people so I can actually have some good formations. Let's see if we can actually pick some people to make me have good formations. Let's see. Lele, Log, Moon. Do I have any more range people? I don't have any range people right now. All I have is a bunch of short-range people. Well, if that's the case, then I guess we'll just bring people who can make things faster. We'll bring Log. We'll go ahead and bring Log. And I wish I had another long-range person, but all I have is all these damn short-range people. Or I guess I could use 3 mid-range, 3 short-range. Right? That's 2 short-range and a long. If I have 1 more short range, I can have 3 in the front, 3 in the back. Let's do that. Let's just bring Lele or Cius. Or not Cornelius. I don't like him too much. Or Cornelio. I don't like him that much. Let's just bring... You know what? I changed my mind. We'll bring in Loon. We'll just bring Log and Loon. my idiot pop's coming? Well, okay. She doesn't want to go if he's going to. And I'm just going to bring a full load of entourage people just to fill in. Just to fill in these spots and actually give me some things. I mean, why not bring them as many as you can if they give you a bunch of passives? Nothing wrong with having a bunch of passives, right? All right, we're good. Let's do it. I am down to clone with this crew. So to kick off our new adventure of what we're supposed to do now, also, while we're here, now that I think about it, might as well do a little bit of this action, because we haven't done this in a while. Holy crap, look how much SP I have. Holy Jesus. Okay. Defense 100%, please. Thank you. Because right now, I'm getting wrecked by everything still. I would love to go faster. Gotta go fast. Hit plus... any hit percentage thing is good, too. Yes, please. Technique, accuracy, yep, do that. Anything... I think I'm gonna probably level this up as good as it gets here. Stamina, max HP plus, yes, please. All that's good. So I maxed out everything I can here. I assume these can all be... Yeah. Maybe we have to find a better combat hall. Maybe that's the point. I don't know. Anyway, let's start getting some of her stuff leveled up. I'm gonna just start with her stamina. I'm guessing, like... These training halls can only go up to a certain skill level, and then you gotta find a better one or something. Anyway, make sure accuracy is good. Make her defense good. Dude, I have hella SP. I did not realize I had that much. I knew my party SP was high, but I did not realize my SP per character was that high. Look at that shit. I'm gonna max out Leon and Funky all the way right now. That's pretty fucking sick, dude. Kyle's stuck because we just started using him. Psyleads fell behind because we didn't have her for a while. Oh, no, she didn't fall behind. I was using her on magic. But she did fall behind. She doesn't have nearly as much. Let's see. Let's give his accuracy some fucking help because that would be nice. Log and Loon, I'm going to go accuracy because they were missing, like, a lot. A lot. You guys were missing, like, a lot. And I don't like that. Oh, one bit. You have a little bit more. Let's go ahead and throw it in some defense. Why not? It's always good to keep them so they can't get their ass handed to them. All right. Was that everybody? Yeah, I guess so. How do I use up my other SP? Can I, like, use my party SP? I probably can. If I just use it, it probably works. I don't want to waste it on Kyle and Siles right now, though. As for Psyleads, I was going to check magic. Psyleads, magic defense or incantation? I'm going to go magic defense, I guess. I don't know. Yeah, fuck it. Don't you love this first part of the episode where all I'm doing is fucking this kind of shit? Let's see. I'm just going to do this formation, I think. I'm down for that. And then let's reposition them all. Let's put him in the front. And actually, that's all I really need to do, huh? I think the rest of the team is good where they are. Yep, I'm happy with that. Let's do it. Yep. Do I have any good pieces of equipment I've been picking up? Or guardian boots? Oh, yeah. Oh, we got armor and stuff. Let's do some equipo. Oh, gotta love all this stuff. Gotta love it. All right, this can go on the Funk. Everything that's best for Funk, we're giving to him first. He gets first picks. Attack plus 10. I'll give that to Leon. Yeah. Let's give it to her. Screw that cape. The cape's weak sauce anyway. Lancer armor. Ooh, Kyle can wear it. Ooh, she can wear it. All right. If she can wear it, it's going on her military uniform. Psyleads? You're telling me, dude. I didn't know Psyleads could wear that shit. Leon already has long boots, so Psyleads is wearing the long boots. Sandals, anybody? No. Cape, we'll give that to somebody who needs something. We'll give it to... Log. Got some more stuff to store. I got all this damn salt, man. All this damn salt. Ooh, more long boots. Let's give them to Kyle. Long boots are better than night boots. That seems weird to me. Log can have those ones. And I guess that'll be all of our logistic stuff. God, I hope so. All right. Let's get it back to what we're doing. I saw Cornelia over there in the corner. Oh, here's my storage guy. Well, let's do some more logistic stuff. Look at the size of this ship, boy. I had no problems doing all the things I bought. Boys. All right, boys. Let's store a few things because I don't need them right now. I'm gonna store these. I'm just gonna make space. I'm gonna keep the fire orb, but I'm gonna get rid of this. No. This one, and this. Oh, yeah. We can store all these shitty. Oops, didn't mean to store the salt. Didn't want to store the salt. Actually, want to make sure we have no salt in here. None. There is no salt belonging in my motherfucking thing. None. Alright, so that's done. Let's get back to business to defeat Godwin. Let's get the fuck out of here. There's Cius and Lele. Alright. You guys ready to do some recruiting? I'm ready to do some recruiting. It's recruitment time. We're not going to recruit everybody in the world, but we're going to start recruiting some peeps. Good thing is, we don't even got to go far to get it started. The first person we're going to recruit is actually here in town, and it's pretty sweet. Pretty sweet. All we gotta do is go over here and go to the inn and be hella queer. You don't gotta be queer though. That part is just added on. Also, what's up, dog? Oh, you're here. Damn. Why must the girls hate me just because I'm from ARMS? I've never even met General Guisu. Cause you're an asshole, Gavaya. Cause you're an asshole. I actually didn't know that guy was here. That was random. Okay, so we're here. Let's talk to... We've already met Retso. We've met Shunmin. That's not who we're here to talk to, though. We're here to talk to... somebody. Oh, you're here. Hello. Norma.
Hey, you're that guy we met in Stormfist, right? There was a big battle after that, so I was worried about you. What a relief to see you again.
You too, Norma. Would you like to join us? Hell yeah, dude.
Join you? What do you mean? Wow, you're the prince? Amazing! I'm sorry, but we have to find that amazing wizard I told you about.
Amazing wizard? What?
The other innkeepers won't let me stay if Ernst is with me. But this innkeeper's really nice.
Okay, so I'm guessing we either have to bring the wizard to her or wait till she actually meets the wizard? I don't know, but she won't recruit us till we meet the wizard. Alright. I'll let you know when I find that wizard, girl. I'll let you know. Ah, this is who we're looking for. This fucking guy. Norden, what up, dog?
Your Highness, I can see that my stories helped you out. This is very painful, but I needed to be done. I'm glad you helped me forward, Lord Barrows. Even so, I still need to pay the price for what I've done.
Okay. Why don't you join? Help Lord Blake out, dude.
Your Highness, are you sure you want a guy like me to join your cause? I'm truly honored to have this opportunity to help you, Your Highness.
All right. That was easy enough. I guess because we helped him out. I don't know if that would have happened no matter what, but he's in there.
I'll make preparations immediately, Your Highness. After I get some coffee.
Yeah. Okay. All right. Enough of Norden. So that's another dude down and another dude down. Sweet. That's who I came here for. We saw Norma. And, well, Norden and Norma. Okay, so I believe there should be at least one other place we could stop by while we're around here, running around here. I'm just not sure where it is. Is it right here? Oh, it is right here. Sweet. So you'll see it's behind, blocking the save point. This is a place that wasn't here before, but now it's here because they're freaking homies now. Hey, homies, you here? Hello? Anybody?
Huh? Oprah's not here. And neither is Fuyo. Something's not right. What?
Who the hell is that guy? Is that Norden?
You.
Oh, shit, no! What? What the fuck is this guy doing here?
I'm shocked to see you here, Mizmar. That's not my name! Why are you here? I'm here to speak with someone. But actually, this is rather fortunate. I must speak with you, too. Will you rejoin us?
What? You're kidding! Why should I do what you ask? I'm the prince's bodyguard, and that means protecting him at any cost. Any cost!
I see. So if His Highness were to disappear, would you rejoin us?
Bitch, don't even threaten me! Don't you even...
No, you can't! I won't allow you to get close to him! If you try anything,
anything at all, I'll kill you, I swear.
Your eyes, just now, they're the same as ours, can't you tell?
I don't care what you say, I'll protect the prince till my last breath. Stand back, prince, please.
Think I'm scared of this little douchebag? I'm scared of this little douchebag.
Prince.
Ah, clients! I'm assuming that's Obro just showing up out of nowhere. Uh-oh. Dude, Dolph, you don't want none, Dolph Lundgren. Don't even, Dolph Lundgren. Go back to fucking Russia where you belong. Go be Ivan Drago. Okay, Dolph Lundgren? Don't even play with me right now.
Ah, forgive my absence. I'm sorry to have kept you waiting.
Yes, indeed, Obero. You're finally back.
Indeed, one moment.
Here you go. Do you know what this is? It's called a business card. That won't be necessary. I know who you are.
Oh, is that so?
Okay, then. No business card for you. I have something I wish to speak with you about.
Ah, yes, so it seems. Anyway, if it's detective's work, I'd be more than happy to listen.
No, forget it. Let's leave it for another day.
Huh. Well, all right then. Please come again.
Okay.
What an unusual person, and who dresses that nice these days? I wonder what he wanted.
I don't really give a shit.
Detective? Thank you.
For what? Ah, you were surely thanking me for the opportunity to witness a hard-boiled sleuth in action, I bet, right? Swift investigations, privacy guaranteed, nothing but the straight facts.
Indeed. It's the only way, man. It's the only way. Alright, so let's talk to them a little bit more. I don't think I'm done with them. Now that we saw that scene, which was really strange. I actually did not expect that. I was just expecting to run up in here and talk to them.
Hello, Your Highness, and welcome. Can I help you with anything today?
Yes, please. I would like you to join, please. Thank you. Come again.
Me? Join the G-Force Army? Really?
Yes, please.
Maybe, just maybe. Maybe I can't just stay indifferent to what's going on anymore.
Uyo, starting today, we'll be providing His Highness the Prince with our utmost cooperation.
Sweet.
What? Right now? Well, if that's what you wish, Detective Obero, then that's what you'll get. Shigure, I expect you to work hard on this move, too.
What the hell?
Ugh, what a pain.
Is it alright if I take a pass?
you lazy bitches.
I'm sorry, but I'd rather not get involved in fighting.
Don't be such bitches.
Sakiri!
Well, I can't force you, but you don't have to leave. You can stay with us, the same as always.
Sound all right, Shigure?
That means I'll be forced to do Sakiri's job too, right? Ugh, what a pain.
Sorry.
Won't be too bad, I guess.
Your Highness.
Starting today, the Obero Detective Agency works exclusively for you, sir.
So we got Obero. We got Fuyo. We got Shigure. Wait, what? Not the third one? Is she really taking a pass? She's not going to join us?
Sorry, Prince, but I can't stand murdering people.
What? Is that really how we're doing this right now? So what, we have to have her join later or something? That's weird. Or is she going to join at all? I don't even know. Anyway, hello. Oh shit, what? Oh, can we start doing like investigations? We can! Oh shit. New people, or people we don't have yet. Oh my god, we can look! Alright, so we've met this guy we met a while back, Al Hazred Babbage. I know where you are. Beston. Where the fuck did I meet him before? I don't know where I remember meeting him, but I remember his small, sad face. Belcoot! Dude, where are you at, dude? Anyway, Bergen. Who the fuck was Bergen? I don't remember Bergen. I remember the face, but I don't remember where the hell that person was met. Anyway, these are people we have. Din. Do we technically not have Din? like, recruited? We might not have Din recruited officially. There's Ernst, Galleon, oh shit, Gavaya. These are people we can, don't have officially recruited yet, I guess. Gunde, Hazwar, Sato, Jean. I'm assuming all these people are people we met. Levi? Yeah, that's the old dude. Okay, Lou. Marina. Oh, okay, of course. Maroon. Oh, is that the name of that little beaver beezy that we met when we walked into the Raffley for the first time? I remember her. Let's see. Miakis. Muller, whatever. Mirad. Nikea. Oh, that's... I forgot about her. That's the girl we met way back in frickin' Stormwall. Forgot about her. Norma. Retso. Sagiri. Yeah, see, Sagiri is gonna be a recruit. Just gotta figure out how to get her. Syro. Shun. Oh, yeah, that dude. Shunmin. So this isn't all 108, is it? No, this is all the people I've met. There's gonna be people in here we haven't met. Look, even Talgeel's here. Sorensen? Who the fuck is Sorensen? I don't know who you are. Have I met you before? I don't think you... I don't think I've met you before, but alright. Erda. We've met her. I'm just trying to see if there's anybody else we haven't met, but pretty much everyone on here we've met. Other than Sorensen. I don't remember him. What do I want to do? I guess I can just do, I mean, I'm going to use a guide to get everyone anyways, so we can just do files and, like, look up background stuff on people. Wait, can we? Oh. I haven't checked on that yet. Oh. Wait. If I pick somebody... Oh, I see. You can. If there's somebody you don't have, you can get whereabouts, and if there's somebody you do have, you can look at their background. I got it. Okay, in that case, I am not going to worry about whereabouts. I'm just going to find somebody we already know, and let's do some background checks on somebody. Let's pick somebody who we know about, or, like, we know has a connection to, like, later games. Like, I wish I could pick George, but he's not even here because he's not officially in our group yet. Egbert, Fuyo, Boz, I don't know. Let's pick Boz. I don't know. It just sounds interesting. We'll come back and figure out some more stuff about Boz later, I guess. All right. We've wasted sufficiently enough time in this episode already doing jack shit. Oh, I got some recruits. I guess it isn't jack shit, but still, we've done very little. So now it's time to do with what... Wait, hold on. Did I get a cutscene? What happened?
Wow! Would you look at that?
The hell?
Whoa, I've never seen real dragon horses before!
Prince, come on over and take a look! Some amazing guys have come!
Some amazing guys? Huh? Oh, Prince? Shit, these guys! I remember them!
You're the dragon guys.
We never met the guys, though.
What a fortunate meeting. I'm Rahal.
Rahal?
The faintest dragon cavalry. And this is my partner, Flail.
Rahal? And Flail is his dragon. Okay.
I'm Rug, and this here is Lance.
Rug and Lance. All right.
We heard the Armus army was meddling in the battle in Northern Rainwall, so we came to investigate. Could you tell us what you know about it?
Sure. Tell you everything I know.
As I see. Thank you for sharing that. I understand now.
So he's been in secret communication with Armus, huh? Unforgivable. What was he thinking? Come on, Lance, let's go.
Where are you going in such haste?
To Rainwall to give Lord Barrows a big old thump on the head, that's where.
But that would be foolish at a time like this. Besides, Lord Barrows is getting up there in years. He might keel over if you hit him, you know?
Don't worry, I'll go easy on him.
Look, just forget about it. You'll disgrace the Dragon Cavalry's name.
All right, fine.
Your Royal Highness, because of Lord Barrow's cover-up, I'm afraid we failed to detect the Armus invasion. We apologize for not fulfilling our duty. So that nothing like this ever happens again, we promise to dedicate ourselves to intel gathering and surveillance.
Does that mean Once you're going to be part of my army?
Thank you for sharing your story with us. Come on, Rug. We're leaving.
Aw, man. Wait, won't you fight alongside us, please? Always ask that. That's a freaking rule of Suikoden. Always ask if they'll join. Whether they join now or later, it's always a good idea. Your Highness. Man, I really wish we could. I'd like to give good Lord Godwin a good old thump on the head even more than Lord Barrows.
fate as dragon cavalry exists to protect the lands and rivers of Felina, and can only be used for self-defense. Therefore, we're forbidden to get involved in internal conflicts. I hope you understand, Your Highness.
Well, just as soon as Lord Godwin tries to fuck you guys over, then you guys can join, okay? I can wait till then. Hopefully you can wait till then.
Now, if you'll excuse us.
Good luck, Prince. See you down the line.
Alright. Well, I'll just have to keep note of those guys. I'm sure we're going to get our hands on those guys, or at least, I should say, recruit those guys eventually. But apparently today will not be that day. All I was going to say is I'm trying to make sure that there's nothing we need to do. I'm wondering... Okay, so we're in... I actually don't want to go this way. Can I use the boat? That's what I was going to go check before that cutscene kicked in. I thought for a second we left. And I was like, what the hell? It didn't ask me if I wanted to leave. I want to see if we can still use the boat. Because I want to go... There's one place I want to go. But I don't think if we're in the area with Lord Lake, then I don't think I can go to where I want to go. I think I have to take the boat back. So I have to go see if Log and Moon will still take the boat to somewhere. I gotta see if those locations are still available. Because I need to go back. I basically need to head back to the Lunas Woods. The area where we met up with the elf path and stuff. I need to go all the way back there. That's the main reason I needed to put Takamoon in the party. Oh, you want to ride, Prince? Log, I guess this is where you come in then, huh? Alright, where are we going? Eastern Wharf, Hod Village, ooh, perfect! Hod Village. Perfect. That's where we want to go. That's very close to where I want to be. Sweet. Take a breath, wait! Hod Village, here we come, yo.
Hod Village, here we come, yo.
Wow, Lord Lake is really nearby, because I can see the shitty forest right there. Don't worry, we'll come back to that. So, for the first time in a while, I think I'm actually going to record, like, two episodes worth of footage right now. So, I'm probably, if you get an abrupt cut at the end of this episode, don't be surprised. I'm just going to keep going through until I have enough for another episode. I haven't done that in a while, but for this Let's Play, well, not just for this Let's Play, but for this weekend, that's just the plan right now. Let us go all the way up here, you hoes. Let's get over to the Hod Village. Take a nice little U-turn, baby. And actually, one of my other destinations while we're over here will be the Revolving Bridge. We need to stop by there as well.
I will do just that. As soon as we dock at Hod Village, we're going to go do two things.
But since I think we're closer to the Lunas North Woods, we're going to do that first. And as for what we're going to do here in Hod, I believe there's a trade shop here. So I think while I'm here, I'm going to go ahead and stop by the trade shop and be like, yo, got any more salt, yo? I need more salt, yo. Give me some more salt before I assault your senses. Give me more salt. Just got to remember where the trade shop is. It's in the middle, right? It's over here, right? Over here, over here, over here. There's a wet... Yep, there it is. Yo, you got more salt or not? Yo. Yo. Yo, 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 yo. Salt. Yep. Nailed it. God, I hope this all leads to me finally getting this guy. I have like 30 salt. I think I might have failed at getting him earlier on. I bought all the salt that I bought, but I didn't hold on to it in my thing. I don't know. I feel like I fucked up. I think I fucked up by buying salt when it was too high of a price. I think that might have been where I fucked up. Anyway, the reason why we brought Takamu is so we can actually get through the Elven Path. That was what I was trying to say earlier before I got sidetracked. I brought him because otherwise we wouldn't be able to go through the Elven Path. What we need to do is we need to get back to that river area. The river area. The area with the river. We don't really need to deal with the elves right now. It's not like we're going to get any of the elf people. This is actually an interesting recruit if it actually lets me do this right now. I really hope so. I really hope so. I certainly hope that this will allow us to recruit this person. I really do. I'm not even going to say who it is, unless you guys already played the game and you know, which most of you probably have. So, if you haven't, that'll be the only way this is a surprise. I just hope I've picked all the right dialogue choices along the way to allow this recruit to finally fucking be a thing. But we shall see. We shall see. Come on.
Come on, come on. Tell me why you're staring. Come on, come on. It must be what I'm wearing.
Why the fuck am I singing in that motherfucking song? I don't know. Stop singing in that weird song. Come on, come on. Tell me why you're staring. Come on, come on. It must be what my funky's wearing.
Because it's better than that stupid orange piece of shit I was wearing earlier. That's for damn sure. I don't even know why that song got stuck in my head all of a sudden. That was weird. That was weird. Alright. Garag! What? Yikes, what was that? Good question. Who's garagging? I don't like this. Please don't hurt me. Who's garagging? Don't garag at me. Okay? And then it just cuts. I'm not going to talk to her right now. We're going to go up to the river and hope that... Yup. Wait, what? This is not what I expected. What the fuck just happened? Oh, it's one of those lizard things. Anyway, it's fucking Zegai, dude.
I'm glad to see you. This is more meat than I can eat myself, and it would be disrespectful to just let it rot. So we must eat meat together.
Glad to see you too, homie.
I have not seen you in a long time. How have you spent your days since? I now have an army. So, you left the House of Barrows. That's good. Barrows with not an honest man. As you can see, I have been living here. I survive off what I hunt. Some might call it a primitive life. It fits me, though. There are enough dangerous animals to keep me happy.
Cool, dude. Can you join?
Very well. As long as you promise you are not associated with the House of Barrows anymore, I can rejoin you. The beasts here are growing familiar. Perhaps it will be good for me to find new opponents.
Sick! We got Zegai! Awesome, dude. I'm actually quite hyped about that. Great, come with us, dude. I'm bringing him. Fuck that. Log and Loon can get the fuck out of here. I'm bringing him. Fuck yeah, dude. I'm gonna drop Mr. or Mrs. Lun. Goodbye, Lun. I don't really need her, so that's fine. Let's do that. Alright, dude, we got Zegai, dude. I'm pretty hyped about this. We got Zegai, baby. So let's put Zegai in the front row. Ooh, he's not even a front row dude, but I'm gonna do it anyways. I'm gonna put him in front over Log, I think. I was gonna put him in front of, instead of Leon, but I didn't realize he was a medium. That's alright, he's a big boy. He could be the front. Alright, cool, we done here then. In that case, let's go ahead and go back. So remember the fact that I talked to Boz and he said something about disabling, or I should say, he didn't say disable, but he basically implied that we should disable the revolving bridge. He said he probably went back across the revolving bridge if it still works or whatever. I even forget what Boz just said. But the fact that I talked to him and he mentioned that actually does mean something, and it's a good thing I did that because I didn't do that on purpose. I just talked to him because I was talking to everybody. But it turns out I glanced over at my shorthand guide, and it said I should talk to him, so that was actually a good thing to do. Because, like I said, our next stop, we're actually going to work our way around and stop by the revolving bridge. Maybe there's a way we could disable that bitch. I don't know. I actually don't know. Are we going to disable something there, or are we just going to go there to meet somebody? I have no idea. I have no idea! Let's beat up this stupid armadillo. You stupid armadillo. Why you gotta miss? Come on. You're better than that, girl. You're better than that.
The road
less traveled is the road you win on. Yeah, go Kyle. I don't know why I haven't, like, cut more. I guess it's just because... I don't know. I just don't like cutting unless I absolutely have to. I do have to walk all the way over to the frickin' bridge. That's gonna take a minute. Should I cut now? I guess I can cut now. Alright, here we are at the revolving bridge. Let's go inside and see what becomes alive. Anything cool? What do you think, dude? Those guys can swing the bridge around whenever they decide to attack, and all we can do is just stand guard. It's quite frustrating, as you might imagine. Of course, there's nothing to be done about it, since the bridge can only be operated from the opposite shore. But I wonder if there's not a way to disable the bridge completely. Ah, I heard that the inventor who designed this bridge lives in Estrazay. Oh. Okay. That makes more sense. Then I guess we'll go back to Estrazay. Yeah, that's what we need to do. Alright, cool. Actually, there's one thing I want to do before we go back to Estrazay, which is actually another long-ass walk we have to do. I want to stop by this big-ass hole over here, because remember the dude that was down here was talking about how he wanted to see a better rune or something? Like I asked him to join, and he was like, not until you have some cool rune power or something. Like, he said something like that. Also, did I talk to you before? Did you say anything interesting? Could this hole be the work of magic? The mere thought of it brings chills up my spine. Right. Didn't we learn why this hole's here already? I forgot why they said this hole was here. Anyway, let's go talk to the dude that was in here with his little friend. This was the one that had the little friend. I was saying, when did we meet that little guy? That's who's in here with this guy. The old rune guy is here with that little snaggletooth bitch. I remember now. Dude, I should probably cut this. This shit is long. I remember this walk being long. Alright, how about this? When I get to him, I'll talk to him, see if he says anything about the fact that I got a Dawn Rune. Maybe I can recruit him right now. I don't know if I can actually recruit him right now, though. My shorthand guide doesn't say go here to recruit anyone. So, I don't know. I just wanted to see if he says anything about the Dawn Rune. I don't know why I'm doing this. I should just follow my shorthand guide. I really should. It's fine. I just want to see if he says anything. Because maybe he'll hint at what else we need to do to get him. Or he'll say something interesting and move on. I don't know. We'll see. Anyway, this gives you an opportunity to see this team at work, though. We'll get a little bit more Kyle. We'll get a little bit more Zagai. Who knows if I'll show much more of this crew or anybody in this crew. I'm going to try to keep mixing and matching new people as we get them. So far, all the people we've recruited, we've used quite a bit in battle. So no need to worry about showing off any of them anymore unless I want to end up using them for long term. Especially freaking Leon. She is forever in my party. Not that she's bad, dude. She kicks ass. I wouldn't want to take her out anyways. Look, more speeders. Speeders for the weasel. Yeah, I'd pretty much say the only two people in this party right now that are guaranteed endgame party members, assuming that it stays that way, are Funky and Leon. I mean, anybody else in this party is possible. I mean, probably not Log, but who knows how good Kyle is compared to other big, you know, strong guys we're going to get. Like, even George is better than him, so George is more likely to be in his spot than him. Or, like, how good is Zagai, really? I don't know. He looks cool. It seems like he's pretty good at damage. And Silesia is probably a pretty good magic user overall. So, I mean, these are possible candidates, but there's going to be so much more characters we get in the game. I can't possibly choose the final party now. So, just going to have to assess what I have and make a choice as we go. But until then, we'll just enjoy everyone for who they are and what they're capable of for the current matters at hand. Now, where the fuck is this guy at so we can get this shit over with? Alright, you. I need to talk to you. God damn it. You fucking listen to this shit one more time. Listen to this, meaning one more battle. My bad. Damn, dude, I'm almost at an episode's worth of time already, too. Jesus Christ. What a very uneventful episode. I'm so glad I'm recording more than one in a row here, because, man, this has been quite the circle jerk of walking and talking and not doing much else. But hey, whatever. It's cool. Probably gonna not even get to Lord Lake in this recording sesh. Nah, we will. We're gonna get there. Anyway, you. I need to talk to you. You.
I sense powerful magic. Do you bear an unusual rune, perhaps?
Yes, indeed, I do.
An unusual rune? You cannot fool me. I can sense the power, and it's emanating from you. It's a symbol of the Felinian royal family. That's the Dawn Rune, is it not?
What the heck is that? Does it blow stuff up? I want to see it, Master.
You, hand that rune over to me this instant.
Bitch, please. It's my rune, homie. Only if you join us. I'm saying it. Only if you join us.
I may be playing into your trap, but if it means getting my hands on that rune... Wait, what am I saying? The choice is hardly mine, or yours, for that matter.
Exactly, dude. It's a fucking true rune, homie. Well, at least I think it's a true rune.
Master Levy? It is said that the rune of the Felinian royal family chooses its master. If such rumors are true, then you could not give it to me even if you had wanted. I can't believe I almost fell for your devilish trickery. Ah, man, I want to see some stuff explode, man. If it is indeed impossible for you to give me the Dawn Rune, then I have no use for you. Be gone!
Aw, really?
That's it? It's truly unfortunate. I could have learned so much from the Dawn Rune. And I could have seen some crazy explosions, man!
Is that it? Alright, well, I guess that's it. God damn it. Alright, well, I guess we'll have to come back for him later. Just going into this hole is a pain in the ass. Meet you back at Estrazay. I'm going to go all the way to Estrazay right now. So, meet you there.